Hello.
Design project number one, soda vending machine. This is team six, and today we'll be going through the six stages of the UX design process that we took on of this for this vending machine.
My major is also UX. Hi, my name is Trace Phoenix, and my major is also UX design. I'm going to begin with the first stage of understanding. To design our soda vending machine, the initial step would involve obtaining a comprehensive comprehension of the machine itself. Our initial approach was to combine our own identified concerns, resulting in a list that involves some of the following. And those are having to look back and forth between the item's code and the keypad and how it can be hard to do for some. Which would cause you to press the wrong buttons. Another concern would be damaging the soda in itself. For instance, if the soda drops too forcefully, you know, it may run the risk of exploding and ultimately causing harm both internally to the machine and externally by having, you know, some sort of puddle of liquid. You know, it would just cause a mess. Finally, fixed positioning of the buttons may result in them being too high or too low for certain individuals. And to move on from the initial phase of solely comprehending the soda machine and recognizing our own individual concerns, we move on to the second phase, which is research. This has us forming interview questions based on our issues to determine if others are also encountering similar difficulties, but from their perspective. Some of the questions we posed included, has your item ever been damaged? Are the buttons easy to find? Where would you rather have them? Do you have a hard time seeing your choices, and have you ever made a mistake on your selection? And again, these were based upon the issues that we just came up on. From there, our interview questions were sort of transformed into survey questions, and this would prove to be more useful in the upcoming stages. As you can see, we maintained a fairly simple approach to the interview questions while also providing the opportunity for our participants to express their thoughts freely in an open-ended response. And those questions were just, please rate the quality of the beverage you received by the vending machine, 1 being you were disappointed, 5 being it was really exceptional. Was the experience trouble-free? Was it informative? Was it prompt? And was it efficient? And this would be a yes or no kind of question. And the open-ended question would be, how could we have made your experience more exceptional? That would give you just the chance to write down, you know, whatever you thought we could change, what you like, and just things upon that nature. And that's all for the second step.
Hi, we are doing the project for the vending machine for our UX design project. And I want to ask him what type of problems he's facing for this type of vending machine which we have in our college. So what do you think? What's your problem?
I thought that it could have been more of a digital display, and that the machine could have had more in stock. Obviously, you can see that it's out of stock with a lot of items. It also doesn't have certain items in stock, like protein shakes or other ones like that. But the system itself could also have smart screen. Say a smart screen would probably be the best for typing in the codes, or maybe even a simpler just touch screen version where you can just type or tap what you want, and then it automatically comes out the price.
So that's what I would say is the best. Thank you. Hi, my name is Geeta. I'm a student of Chattahoochee Technical College. My major is UX design. Today I'll be talking about the stage 3 user persona. Hi. taken the example of Daisy. Her age is 32, location Marietta. She is a nursing student by profession. She is busy by nature. Scenario: Daisy actually uses vending machine several times a week. She needs to make a quick stop for a drink. As she runs through a day, she is always looking for the most efficient place to get her daily intake of liquids. Being a student as she can, she needs to be punctual with her timings. Waiting in the lines are such a hassle for her. In that case, a local vending machine is best option for her if nobody is using it. Wants and need. She wants a vending machine that accepts all forms of payment. She needs a better way to choose her drinks. She wants to buy multiple drinks at time. She wants that even before she is at vending machine can choose and pay for her drinks. Pain points. She always carry her phone but forgets her wallet at home sometimes and can't pay when she is thinking of purchasing any of the drink. Her schedule is very tight, so sometimes she can't wait in lines. She has also complained about that soda occasionally burst when she opens it. So these are the pain points, scenario, and the wants of Daisy. Thanks. This is all about the user persona.
Using the analysis user persona as
stage 4, design and wireframe.
Using the analysis user persona as our North Star, we came up with individual rough draft designs without each other's influence. Then, once finished, we came together to compare and contrast. What we all had familiar was a touchscreen display and multi-site function. We all agreed that steps between looking for your item to punching into the keypad was inefficient. In between those steps counted for more mistakes to occur. With the multi-site function, it can reduce time of waiting into at least 50%. For the soda vending machine company, that's more sales. And for the customers, users, or students, that's less wait. It's a win-win situation. For disagreement, we had it over the overall shape, which was a fun but short dispute. This led into our final design. Something sleek and minimal. A two-sided functional soda vending machine, meaning not just one, but two people could be using it at the same time. Already reducing time to half, like we talked about earlier. Next, we have the main touchscreen display. The screen will display direct choices of items. This allows users to directly point, touch, and touch at the selection of their choosing. With all payment options like card, insert, swipe, tap, cash, and coin, we included a QR code that will direct you to a web-based app menu where you can select and pay from your phone. The vending machine will dispense once finished. Next is one of our biggest implementations, the conveyor belt multi-drink dispenser. This is where users can select more than one drink at the same time and only need to pay once. As of before, if someone wanted to buy two drinks, they had to go through the process of selecting, paying, dispensing, and retrieving twice. The conveyor belt dispenser also has a controlled delivery where items get dispensed safely all at once. And here is a corner view of our final design. We also wanted to point out that we wanted to be a corner unit. From Team 6,